Hey there, it's Matt from Style Factory, the go-to site for e-commerce reviews and advice. In this Shopify SEO guide, I'm going to walk you through the key steps you need to take to make sure your store ranks highly in search results. So stay tuned to the end to get all our tips on how to increase your Shopify store's organic traffic and sales. But before I get going, just a quick reminder to subscribe to our channel and click the notifications bell. This means you won't miss out on any of our Shopify content going forward. Right, let's start with something that's quick and easy to do, but also very important: telling search engines that your site exists. 1. Register your site with Google Search Console and Bing Webmaster Tools. Registering a site with Google Search Console and Bing Webmaster Tools is a key starting point for Shopify SEO. By registering your site with these services, you're telling Google and Bing about your website and helping it to get indexed faster. Once you've registered your site with these services, you then need to submit a sitemap to them. Helpfully, Shopify generates a sitemap automatically for you. It's simply yourdomain.com/sitemap.xml. In both Search Console and Bing Webmaster Tools, you can submit this sitemap URL by going to your site's dashboard and then clicking Sitemaps. 2. Ensure your Shopify store is loading quickly. Search engines give fast sites preference over slower ones. To ensure that your Shopify store loads as quickly as possible, remove any Shopify apps that you don't need, avoid using a large number of web fonts on your site, use image compression tools like TinyPNG to reduce the size of your store's pictures, keep use of external scripts on your store to a minimum. 3. Do your keyword research. A key part of improving your Shopify store's search rankings is to ensure that your store's pages and products contain the keywords that people are actually searching for. To do this, you'll need to perform keyword research. Keyword research typically involves getting three key pieces of information: the keywords that people are using when looking for sites or products like yours, the volume of searches for these keywords, how difficult it is to rank for each keyword. When you have these three pieces of information, you can identify sweet spots, keywords that are popular enough to generate a reasonable amount of traffic without being so popular that there are lots of other sites already dominating search results for them. Getting this data involves using dedicated keyword research tools like Ahrefs or SEMrush. These let you find out how popular your preferred keywords are and how difficult it will be to rank for them. You'll find links to more information about Ahrefs and SEMrush in the video description. 4. Get your page and product titles right. One of the most important elements of a web page is its title. Search engines treat it as a key piece of information when categorizing your content, and your title shows up as the largest component of a search result. You should ensure that your Shopify page and blog post titles are never vague in nature, and always start with your target keyword. To edit your homepage title in Shopify, click Online Store, Preferences in your store's dashboard. Then, use the box provided to enter your homepage title. To edit other page titles, just navigate to your page, post, or product in your Shopify dashboard. Then, scroll down to the bottom of its settings and click the Edit Website SEO link on the search engine listing preview. You'll then be able to edit your title. 5. Use headings properly. Instead of using bold text to break up the text for your Shopify pages or products, always apply heading 1s, 2s, 3s, and so on to do so. This will make it much easier for search engines to index your content accurately and will also make it more accessible to any of your store visitors who have a visual impairment and use screen readers. 6. Use engaging meta descriptions. Meta descriptions are the summaries of web pages that appear under page titles in search results. Although Google says that they aren't a ranking factor, a well-written meta description can encourage more click-throughs to your website. And because the click-through rate of a search result is considered a ranking factor, it's important to get meta descriptions right. Your meta description for your Shopify products and pages should be short, 120 to 156 characters in length is best, be accurate, include your target keywords. To edit your homepage's meta description in Shopify, click Online Store, Preferences, and enter it into the homepage meta description box provided. To edit a meta description for other types of pages, locate your page, post, or product in your Shopify dashboard, and then scroll down to the Edit Website SEO link in the search engine listing preview. You'll then get the option to edit your meta description. 7. Ensure your product titles and descriptions are unique. A common way of speeding up the process of adding products to a Shopify store involves using the Duplicate Product option. While this is a quick way to add a new product to your store, it can lead to a lot of similar or even entirely duplicated product titles and descriptions being created. This is something that search engines' algorithms don't like. So always try to make your product titles and descriptions as unique as you can. 8. Optimize your alt text and image names. Search engines don't just examine the words on your Shopify store when indexing it. They factor in its images too. To do this, they look at two bits of data associated with your pictures: alt text and file names. To add alt text to images on Shopify pages or posts, navigate to your page or post, locate the relevant picture, and double-click on it. You'll then see a box appear containing an alt text field. Enter your alt text in here, making sure that it contains any necessary target keywords, while still making sense to those using screen readers. To add alt text to product images, navigate to your product in your Shopify dashboard, then click on the relevant product image. Click the alt text option to the right of the image to add your alt text. As for optimizing file names, changing them is not particularly easy in Shopify, so it's best to optimize your file names before you upload them to the platform. This means ensuring your focus keyword is in the file name and that the file name is short. If you do have to change an image file name after you've uploaded it to Shopify, you'll need to delete your existing image and re-upload a version that contains your focus keywords in its file name. Nine. Use clean URLs. Using clean, SEO-friendly URLs is something that is encouraged by Google. Clean URLs are short, simple, and easy to understand. For example, if you were selling a red guitar on your store, it would be better to use a URL slug of red guitar for the relevant product page instead of something long and complicated. To edit a URL in Shopify, go to the page, product, or post you wish to edit, scroll down to the bottom of it, and then click Edit Website SEO. Then, enter your URL into the URL and Handle box. If you are changing an existing URL, make sure that you tick the Create URL Redirect option. This prevents users and Google encountering broken links and lets Google know that you have changed the URL. Now, changing the URLs of pages that aren't currently performing well in search results is usually fine. But if you're thinking about changing the URL of a page that is already ranking highly, it's often best to take an "if it ain't broke, don't fix it" approach. Changing the URL of a popular page can also affect its social proof, because it will reset the stats displayed on your social shares counter for that page to zero. 10. Add rich snippets to your products and pages. Rich snippets are pieces of structured data that can be added to your content to help search engines and users understand what a page is about. Rich snippets provide additional information about the content of a product, page, or post, for example, star ratings, author, or prices. There are a couple of ways to add rich snippets to a Shopify store. The first is to manually add some data markup code to your Shopify templates. You'll find a link to a resource to help you with this in the video description. The second approach is to use a Rich Snippets app. There are lots of these available from the Shopify App Store. 11. Use your Shopify blog to drive traffic. Sites that feature in-depth, informative blog posts on topics that people are interested in tend to perform much better in search results than those that don't. Shopify comes with a really good blogging tool, so make sure you make the most of it. You should aim to regularly post high-quality posts about key topics in your product niche. You can learn more about how to blog effectively in the Style Factory Guide to Increasing Blog Traffic. You'll find a link to this in the video description. 12. Build backlinks to your store. Backlinks are links from another site to yours, and they are a really important part of SEO. This is because search engines view backlinks as votes for the quality of a piece of content. Generally speaking, the more backlinks you have to the products and pages on your Shopify store, the better they'll rank in search results. To get backlinks, you usually have to reach out to other site owners in your niche and persuade them to link to your content. This can be hard, but it's easier to do if the content you've created on your store is really strong. One thing that you should generally avoid doing is buying links. Search engines are wise to this practice and can penalize your site in search results if they discover evidence of it. Link swap schemes can be risky too. And that's it. 12 key tips to help you improve your Shopify SEO. I hope you've found this video useful, but if you're interested in learning even more about how to boost your rankings, check out the free Style Factory SEO Toolkit. This contains a host of useful resources, including downloadable cheat sheets and extended free trials of popular SEO apps, and you'll find a link to it in the video description. To get more SEO content from Style Factory in future, remember to like this video, subscribe to our channel, and hit the notifications bell. Finally, if you have any questions about Shopify SEO, just leave them in a comment below this video. We read them all and we'll do our best to help.